What is going on, you guys? In today's video, I'm doing a review on the already released Transformers Rise of the Beast Buzzworthy exclusive Optimus Prime. So yes, this is probably a review y'all were waiting for. I found this guy 3 weeks ago at a Target. He's a pretty good figure. He's not that underrated, but he's a very good figure. We got the packaging. It's not the best for Studio Series, but I mean, I guess it's alright, you know. I'm not gonna transform this figure, due to the fact that I don't want to damage it, because that's what happened to previous of my Transformers from Bayverse. But there's a couple issues about this figure, but not many, alright? So these usually pop off because they sometimes get in the way when you're like, when you're moving around the leg. As you can see, put them around, you know, so yeah, that usually happens. So yeah, it's not that really big of a deal, but yeah, you know. So here we got the figure itself. It comes with two weapons. It comes with sword. You can see that we saw him using the final battle. He also comes with his blaster, I guess you would call it, or cannon. Many people are complaining it's quite small. For me it's fine, I guess. But many people are getting the upgrade kit just to fix that problem. But I don't really have an issue with that. So this pegs with peg that it has inside. Both of these hands have it. So. Can see you could peg it on both of them. You just have to flip over this piece. So yeah, it's quite complicated sometimes to get them out. So there we go. You just want to put this piece back. So yeah, you know, it's basically has that mechanism. You basically put it inside here. Boom. All right. So now for the blade. Let me just put this out. For the blade, there's two options. You could use this this peg right here, like as we saw in the War for Cybertron. This won't fit the War for Cybertron figures. It's much smaller, so it's the only figure I know it's compatible with. It's this Optimus. Besides that, it's not compatible with any. If you want to peg it. But by holding it like this, it's compatible with a lot of the figures, most of them. So yeah, so basically you just want to peg it right there. You could peg it like that, or you have another option. So right here, it has this like little peg thingy. You could stick this in. So you just want to like slide it in on top and just close it. It looks much better and accurate, like it appeared in the movie. So I usually keep them like this. Both of the sides have it again. So you basically want to go again over here again. Just pop it in there. So yeah, you could just put it on both hands. I prefer it being on the right hand because this thing sticks out a lot. And I don't really like it. As you can see, you can just put it right there. And it looks much better, as you can see. So yeah. These are very cool accessories. I really like that it came with. Many people are having problems with the smokestacks, that they're too big. I mean, for me, they're all okay, you know. I kind of got used to it. At first, they were kind of big. You know, I was complaining that. But now that, you know, I have them for a while, I like it. I like the design. Honestly, the DNA design, did the upgrade kit and all, and put another smokestacks on this guy, but they don't look that good because they're like this height, I believe. They don't really look that, they look small, you know. So the bigger smokestacks does fit this Optimus. So yeah, he has very good head articulation. Honestly, you could look that up, you know. That is a very good range of looking up, you know. You could have him like posing. If you're like those type of people that like taking, you know, photography of figures, you know, you could like take a picture of Optimus, you know, looking up, You know, as we saw in the movie, when he's looking up and he sees Unicron arriving to Earth's atmosphere. So, you know, just have him like that, like in the movie where he had his blade, you know, looking up. That looks very cool, honestly. So yeah, you know, you can have him like that, or you can have him like running, charging into battle. Like that, you know. Looks very cool. So yeah, you know, he's a very good figure. One of the things that people are kind of complaining with, it's they're calling this Optimus overrated. But what I think is happening is that this Optimus Prime's availability is probably making it overrated. It's very hard to find, honestly. Like, it's I've only seen this guy once, and I never saw him again. So yeah, that's one of the problems. So yeah, you know, you barely see any of these. Usually Target stock like one or two of these. So yeah, that's a big deal for a lot of people. But yeah, you know, but one of the things I really like about this figure is the posing. He literally has a ab crunch. Like, that is very cool. I am not bending it down. Look, as you can see, it's an ab crunch. See, as you can see in the back, it's an ab crunch. So none of the previous Optimus Primes had it. So that is very cool. So I'm going to show you the articulation now. The arm has a good bend, honestly. Very good. So yeah, both of these have a good bend. As you can see, head could look that up, side to side. You could look that down. You can't really look that down, but he looks all right. You could do a 360, as every single one can. Leg spread like that. You know, that's very high. You can have a bend like that. So yeah, he has a 60 degree bend, or 90, throughout there. So yeah, you know, articulation is good. He's a very good figure. So now I'm gonna compare height with him. So now I'm going to bring out Studio Series Rise of the Beasts Battle Trap. So let me just take this guy out. So here you got these two. As you can see, Battle Trap is almost by the shoulder of Optimus. It's slightly shorter, you know, by a little, but you know, yeah, that's the height comparison right there. And then we're gonna take out Studio Series Rise of the Beast Cheetor. As you can see, there's a height comparison. It's kind of the same thing when it comes to height with so let me just align this figure. So as you can see, he's nearly by the shoulder. He's like the Battle Trap, same height, I think. Well, Cheetor being a slightly taller, but yeah, you know, Optimus Prime tops him. And then we have Studio Series Rise of the Beast Air Razor. So as you can see, Air Razor doesn't really reach like by his hip. But yeah, you know, it's not a big figure. You know, it is big, big figure, but what I mean is like by how tall it is. So yeah, but this is probably best comparison. Here we have Transformers Rise of the Beasts Studio Series Scourge. So as you can see, Scourge slightly tops Optimus. So you can have these two in a lot of dynamic poses. So yeah, you know, Optimus is compatible with these blades that came with the KO Nemesis Prime. So yeah, you know, you could just take this off, put it on, and look at that. You can have them like in Bayverse slicing those Decepticons. So yeah, now we can have Scourge posing with Optimus. As we saw in the Museum battle, when Optimus Prime says impossible and Scourge says, I enjoy that look of confusion when an inferior being meets a higher power. So yes, this looks very cool, honestly. Like these two, man, these looks awesome, man. Like, you know, it's a dream come true, you know. Like these two, two of my favorite Transformers, you know, face to face, as you can see. So yeah, these are two cool figures. Please, if you have the opportunity, don't not like pass by this figure, buy it instantly, because it's gonna be gone. You know, by the time you'll want it, you won't have it, because it's gonna be gone. eBay price is going throughout $70 to $100. Price is increasing, so get this figure. Thank you for watching, guys. Till the next one, see you.